today is to introduce Gus Wagner. He's from Jefferson City, Missouri, and is the president owner of The Racket Group, which is an award-winning marketing and communications firm. The Racket Group has specialized in building effective tools across traditional means and new media for clients in businesses, organizations, and nonprofits since 2001. Gus has worked with clients from the Fortune 100 like MasterCard and Phillips 66 to local businesses and organizations such as the Missouri Association of School Administrators and the Jefferson City Concert Association, all to achieve social media success stories. Gus is also a five-time certified social media strategist, a former chief of staff in the state, or Missouri State Senate, and a retired national champion amateur hockey coach. Finally, he would love to be a singer and songwriter. But here's the thing, people say he can't sing. I give you Gus Wagner. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. And I would say that introduction was too wordy, but I wrote it. So I was probably just the right amount of words. Can everybody hear me? I know we got some clatter and pizza eating going on here. Please take your time in the line. We've got a hard 1 o'clock deadline on the end of this, so we wanted to get started here. Welcome to MRJBC. You guys have been doing a great job on social media the past couple of days. I'm following along. Me and NSA have been watching everything you're tweeting. And we're glad to be back with y'all today. As was mentioned, I'm Gus Wagner. I own the Racket Group. We are that business marketing firm, creative services firm here in Jefferson City. The most important thing that was mentioned in the bio and in here today is I'm a five-time certified social media strategist, working with firms like Think Suite and Social Media Examiner and HubSpot to be certified in ever-changing world of social media. Since this presentation was booked, since T and I first discussed this, Periscope has gone through a world of changes. Other social media platforms have gone through a world of changes. This stuff never stands still because all of these platforms are in competition for your eyes, your ears, your fingers, and your attention. So you spend more time on their platforms than somebody else's platform. So, you can't hear me in the back?
You hear me in the back? So they're all in competition because they want your attention and your clicks on the ads on these platforms. So that's why these social media platforms change on a constant basis. If you are tweeting or periscoping today, I don't know if we have the Wi-Fi signal strength for everybody to periscope in the room, but that'd be kind of cool. I'm at Racket Group on all of the major social media channels, and our website is racketgroupllc.com. And I believe there were some handouts passed around the tables earlier with the rest of our contact information, and we'll address that in a second. So today, we're going to give you a quick overview of the live streaming world. We're going to talk about some best practices. We're going to talk about uses for you as real estate professionals with the live streaming app. And then we're going to have a panel discussion here. You thought we were going to sing on this stage, didn't you? Well, we're going to have a little panel discussion about what's going on with Periscope and in the real estate world. So, anybody recognize this logo? No. This is Meerkat. Meerkat was the first to market with a solely devoted social media platform devoted towards live streaming. And what live streaming is being able to take your mobile device, your tablet, or your phone, and use the camera on there and hook up through these applications like Meerkat and the others and broadcast out to the world. And people, maybe they have followed you and you have a follower list, or maybe they stumbled upon you that you're doing a broadcast, but it's basically like having your own little TV show in the palm of your hand, and you can talk about whatever you want to talk about, however long you want to talk about, and use it to the best of your abilities. So that's how live streaming works. It's just using the camera on your phone to broadcast to the world. Meerkat was first to market at the beginning of 2015 with the new world of live streaming applications. And what is normal with the first to market is that they've been slowly and surely replaced by other platforms as other developers and other social media companies developed tools to to do things a little bit different, a little bit stronger, a little bit better, what have you. Meerkat still exists, but it is by no means the market leader anymore. Periscope, when it comes to live streaming, would be considered the market leader at this point. Today, right here at 12:15 on January 21st, 2016, they would be the market leader in the live streaming app world. And Periscope, again, is another company that offers live streaming services. They are actually owned by Twitter. Twitter acquired them around the third quarter of last year. And Twitter is slowly but surely incorporating Periscope into their Twitter applications. In fact, it was just announced last week, and every Periscoper I know in the world flipped out and had a parade about this, that if you Periscope and connect it to your Twitter account, which you should always do, your Periscope will now be in the Twitter stream of all of your Twitter followers. Instead of them having to click a link to go to the Periscope app, or the Periscope website, or to watch it later, they can watch it right there in their Twitter stream. And this is huge, because the audience of Twitter is a million times bigger than the total audience of Periscope. And if people see in their Twitter feed, their Twitter news feed, as they're scrolling through, they see that you're doing a Periscope broadcast, they are much more likely to stop and watch that broadcast than to click and watch it on another platform that they may or may not have downloaded on their device. So this is very exciting news. It's currently available only on iOS. Team Android, which I'm a proud member, will be coming along very, very shortly, probably by the end of this quarter. So that's very cool. As a matter of fact, did you guys get the vodka? This is pretty good vodka. Periscope and live streaming have grown to such levels that just last week in San Francisco, they held the second Periscope Live Summit, where hundreds of people traveled to San Francisco to basically a conference just like this, wrapped solely around the world of Periscope and the Periscope leaders, the leading Periscope voices that are using the application. So it's already got its own convention. That's how cool and fast Periscope is growing. Stepping back a little bit further, when it comes to live streaming apps, and something that you have available to you as well if you use any of the Google suite of tools, is the Google Hangout, which Google Hangouts allows you to have up to 10 people in a Hangout room conversation. Maybe it's around a topic, maybe it's taking the place of a conference call, maybe it's whatever, and you can make these private, or you can make these so they are public, and they are broadcast out to folks, but you would have to share the link to this Hangout room. There's some proactive steps that you have to take. Hangouts are kind of cool. Hangouts have a lot of purpose to them, but they've never really caught on with the public as a whole. Not as much as what this is called Blab. Anybody heard of Blab? It's one of the new shiny tools. It's been out for about 6 months right now. It's starting to lose a little bit of its shininess because it's not that new, but if a Google Hangout and Twitter had a baby, this would be Blab. And you can have up to four people at one time in a Blab room. Here you sign in, and again, it's all based on your Twitter account. It's all connected to your Twitter account. This is the live chat room where the people that are watching the show can chat about what's going on or pose questions to the people who are in the Blab on the screen here. The host here, like this guy, he can invite people in to come into what they're called seats, and they can come in and join the room to have the maximum of four folks there. Then you also have social media share tools on this side here where you can tweet and Facebook to share that this Blab is going on live. And there's almost like a TV guide for Blab now these days. If you want to look it up, it's Blab, BLAB.IM, or just Google hashtag Blab, and you'll find information about this. But this is a very cool tool. We follow a lot of things that are going on in the Blab world, and are getting ready to launch probably end of first quarter a series of our own Blabcasts And I think that there's a lot of real estate professional, a lot of real estate content going on and being discussed on Blab. So if you go to that website, you'll be able to find some folks, some of your peers from across not just the country, but the world, who are having interactive conversations. Are you familiar with Facebook Live? You're about to be, not just because I'm going to talk about it, because it's going to be in your face every time you turn on the computer or look at your phone. Facebook Live is currently live to celebrities and media outlets. You see The Rock, my good friend The Rock here. No relation, The Rocket Group and The Rock, no relation. If this is Facebook's live streaming app, you'll be able to broadcast live from your phone, from your tablet, not from your desktop, but through your Facebook page. And at this point, when they turn it loose to everybody, probably somewhere in the beginning of the second quarter of this year, when they turn it loose to everybody on Facebook, all these other tools will probably go away very quickly. And it will become a Facebook Live dominated world because of the 1.2 billion people who are on Facebook on a daily basis will now have their own live streaming tool to do whatever they wish to do with, including yourselves. So be ready and beware of Facebook Live. Not beware, but beware that that's going to be clogging up your news feeds on Facebook very, very soon. This is what Facebook Live looks like. This is an example. This is a radio station out of Dallas. They have access to it. It's very limited access to the Facebook Live at this point. They were Facebook Live broadcasting a couple of concerts. Well, this one here on the right, my left is I guess it's all of our lefts if I'm facing the screen. This was a concert that they were broadcasting from a concert venue last week in Denver. The quality was like I was in the room. It was outstanding. The network, the infrastructure that Facebook has to support this live broadcasting, this live streaming is just outstanding. The thing here, if you look, this was the first broadcast that 95.9 did. It was an in-studio interview, and they had the camera held the wrong way, for one thing. But the most important deal was, if you look, I caught it when it ended, after 5 minutes after it ended, and this radio station has about 10,000 likes, give or take. They had 45 likes, 38 comments, 5 shares, and 382 views in that 5-minute live broadcast. We do a lot of video work. We have a lot of content up on YouTube. We have a lot of content up on the live streams and such. We've never achieved 382 views on any type of our live efforts. Even some of the Periscope leaders, those people who were in San Francisco last week, do not achieve that during their live broadcast. This is where as far as strategic terms, not like how to push the on button for this. So it'll apply across all of these. So best practices for Periscope. The important thing is, whether it's Facebook, Periscope, Meerkat, whatever, you can go out and do these broadcasts, do these live stream broadcasts. But if they're, especially the other ones, and Facebook as well, if you don't have any audience on any of the, on Twitter or Facebook, the live streaming is not really going to help you, because you're going to be talking into an empty room if you haven't titled your Periscope correctly, where people might just stumble upon it, find it. But if you're connected to your Twitter and you have 10,000 Twitter followers or 1,000 Twitter followers, your Facebook fans or what have you, and that you simulcast to those other platforms, those audiences are going to be connected to your Periscope or your other live streaming, and you're going to be impacting the audience that you've already built. So if you don't have any audience, live streaming video on the other social media platforms, live streaming video is not really the place to start. You've got to build the foundation of Twitter and Facebook before you can go into the live streaming and be truly effective. That make sense? Yes, no, maybe?
Yeah.
Okay. Archive. There's a way to get around this though. If you want to live stream, if you really want to do this, you can't live stream. The thing about all these live streaming videos is they only exist online for 24 hours. After 24 hours, they're deleted off the Periscope servers, the Meerkat servers, the Blab servers. So what you need to do is either record them, I say that as he takes a picture, you either record them as they're happening somehow through a screencast application, or you record them after the fact. There's a tool out there called CatchMe, KATCH.ME, that if you connect that to your Periscope account, it will automatically record and then do an automatic send out, again, as soon as that recording is available to your social media audiences that you connect it to. And then you also can take that recorded file and embed that into your other web presence, your website, what have you. Share that on your Facebook page, again, to archive the live streaming video that you are live streaming. This is very important, and it's something that took me a while to learn, and I still mess it up, and a lot of people mess it up, but it's very important to, when you're broadcasting, here's a good picture for you. Look at the camera lens at the top of your phone, okay? Look at that lens when you're talking to your audience, not here in this big screen that's showing your face, that's showing your reflection. Because when you look at this, you're actually looking downward. It's not a straight shot and a straight visual. You're not talking to your audience, you're talking away from your audience. This is the camera lens, just like that's the camera lens, or this is the camera lens right here. You need to look at that lens. I'm smiling. You need to look at that lens to get the best presentation, the best live stream presentation for the people who are watching you. Does that make sense? It's a very easy thing to flub, but it really impacts the quality of your presentation. Wi-Fi is a huge issue when it comes to live streaming. As I mentioned at the beginning, we wouldn't have enough Wi-Fi strength. Is anybody broadcasting? Are you periscoping over here?
I'm not.
You're just taking pictures? Okay. We wouldn't have enough Wi-Fi signal in this room, because all of us in this room are connected to the Wi-Fi right now, to do a Periscope broadcast. If you're at a coffee shop, you might not have it. I've done them from all sorts of locations, but the best ones, if I can set up my tripod and set my phone on top of my tripod and just do it from my office, where I'm like 3 feet away from the router, where I've got the strongest Wi-Fi signal strength, that you're gonna have the best success. Even the professionals have issues with this. This was a one I happened to catch yesterday. DC Comics, it's a big week for them, announcing a billion Batman things or something are going on. They're in New York City, or they're in LA, Burbank, California, and they didn't have enough Wi-Fi strength to do their Periscope, so they had like 3 false starts before they could do this. The guy on this side right here, his name is Joel Kahn. He is very big in the Periscope. He was the co-host of the Periscope Summit. He does his from his office, and I don't know why he continues to do it. He does one every day or every afternoon, and he does not have the strength. You see the pixelation here on the screen? This is a common thing on the live streaming apps, to have your images pixelated. You don't have a quality presentation because of the Wi-Fi signal dropping out. It depends. On the strength of the connection and what else might be connecting with it. Be ready for awkwardness. Operating these live stream apps is very awkward in the case sense that when you turn them on, the cameras are facing outward. So if I turn on right now, this table would be the first view that my audience saw. And then I hit it real quick, and you kind of fumble while you're doing it, and sometimes it connects. It's just weird how it works sometimes. I don't know why it starts with the outward view instead of the selfie view, but that's what happens on Periscope, that's what happens with the other apps. Even turning off, stopping the broadcast, it's a swipe motion. And if you don't catch it the first time, you're broadcasting yourself going, dang, son of a, and then you can stop your broadcast. So it's gonna be awkward. And your presentation will freeze out, again, because of Wi-Fi strength and stuff, and people will be able to capture goofy faces, derpy faces of you on screen captures if you're doing such. Be ready for interruptions, just like having your picture taken while you're having a presentation here. Be ready for your interruptions. And what I mean by interruptions, interruptions during a live stream are excellent. You want interruptions. Why? Why do you want interruptions? Anybody? People are interacting with you, as I think you were trying to say, if you didn't say it. people are interacting with you. This is my friend Brian Fanzo out of Pittsburgh. He's one of the, he was the other co-host of the Periscope Summit last week in San Francisco. And you'll see here, when you're live streaming, the people, as people join your room, this will scroll up and say, Millionaire Talk invited, well, there's, this is invited followers here, but people are commenting on his, on what he's saying there. People are joining and sharing the room. These little hearts here, these are the Facebook like of Periscope. You hit your screen while somebody's broadcasting and hearts go up and your words point. It's kind of a video gamification kind of thing with this. But you see how Brian's looking away because he was giving a recap summit, a recap conversation of the summit last week, and there's so much interaction. There's so much interaction from these 170 some people that were watching this broadcast live yesterday afternoon that he kept losing focus and he kept wanting to engage with the people. Now, we have smaller audiences like everybody in this room would have from the start and maybe until you get tired of Periscope. If somebody joins the room, welcome them. If somebody comments, answer the question. If somebody shares to their followers, thank them right there. It's all about the interaction. This is still social media. This is not, yes, it's a broadcast tool, but you're not reading the 6 o'clock news. You're trying to interact with your followers and grow an audience and help the people that are watching you and provide value. So what can you as real estate professionals do? We're gonna go through this real quick because I was just given a 5 minute signal. Take all these live streams that you've done and record them and embed them in your website. Share them into your other social media channels while they're still live. Give people notice before you're going up on a live stream. At 8 o'clock, say that I'm 12 o'clock and I'm going to be on Periscope. Give people notice, try to build that audience before, during, and after the live stream event. So video blogging, use it as a video blogging tool for your website, which we all have, right? We all have websites? Very good. Testimonials. It could be a cool thing for you at the close of a sale or something like that too. So if the people are willing to do a live stream interview with them, hey, what did you tell me about the house you bought? Tell me about the process. Tell me about what did you think of me? That kind of stuff. Gather that testimonial right there. It's just like an interview thing. How was the sale? She said it was awesome. So the same kind of thing, and then you go back and record that and capture that and put that into your website where underneath all your testimonials, you've got that. Show your personality. Don't read from a script. Use notes, use bullet points if you have to, but if you're gonna sit there and read the 6 o'clock news, you're not gonna be very effective. People wanna see the personality. People wanna hear your actual tone. People wanna hear the actual news, your opinions, what have you. They wanna see how you react to the interactions. You're gonna get trolls who come in and start talking dirty to you during these presentations. That's really the best part. But people, your opposition, your loyal opposition might come in and start tweaking you or trying to hit your buttons while you're doing this live presentation as well, so be ready for that. These are the type of things that might be happening to give an opportunity for you to show your true personality. Something that Periscope and the live streaming apps can do is allow you to be the cutting edge real estate professional in your community, your region, your state, your nation. I don't know how many real estate professionals are using it as an actual marketing slash sales tool. The ones I see out there are more like, follow me and I'll tell you all the secrets to selling to becoming the $1 million broker. There's a lot of that stuff going on out there. But if you want to use it as a marketing sales tool for yourself, for your business, for your community, for your properties, the opportunity is there. And you can be the cutting edge person who's doing it through live streaming apps. And it gives you the chance to show, don't tell. The next slide is gonna kind of contradict what I'm about to say. But there are opportunities for you to show a property or show your office or show how it is that you do your job or show the process of a closing, things like that, the how-to kind of stuff of your business. It's a good opportunity for live streaming. What it's not a good opportunity for is open houses and showcases and things like that. And this all goes back to the Wi-Fi strength. If you're selling an empty house, there's no Wi-Fi strength in an empty house. Or in a building that has a lot of steel and glass in it, which will block Wi-Fi signals. You're gonna take a risk by trying to live stream from that type of area, of facility. So I don't recommend it for that type of stuff, but everything up to and including, or up to the point of the open house, the actual presentation. Still use your phone, still use your video capabilities to market your properties, but I don't really think live streaming is the best opportunity for it to do that. And with all of this, I mentioned building value. This is one of our TRG rules, which were passed, some of them were passed out, our first 10 have been published. There's about 300 that we've got written out so far. It's been an ongoing publication online. We appreciate you all connecting with this. We're glad to talk to you afterwards. But the key to all of this, to social media, live streaming or not, is to help before you sell. Help them to understand who you are. Help them to understand the market. Help them to understand what it is they're about to get into, whether it's buying or selling a piece of property. Provide value to your audience before you go out and do the selly sell. On social media, you have to earn the right to do the sale. You have to build the trust in your audience, just like you do in the real world. In the real world, you might try to sell somebody before you built value in them, and they might just turn you off. But in social media, if you're doing that, they're going to start bad-mouthing you online, basically. We see it happen all the time. You end up in one of those burn books. We've got a burn book Facebook page for Jefferson City here. I'm sure I know they're in other communities as well. These are opportunities for people to negatively engage with you if you haven't earned their value, if you haven't earned their trust yet. So always, 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 especially with live streaming, help before you sell. That concludes this portion of the presentation. Thank you.
Thank you guys, and thank you guys for all that information. So I'd like to invite our panel up here as we go through some questions. I've got a couple that we thought we'd start with, but again, we want to try to leave some time if you guys have some questions for the panel as well. So I'd like to introduce, of course, Gus is gonna come join us on the panel, but we also have Michelle Walker, a realtor from St. Charles County Association, and we have Andre Gray from the Kansas City Regional Association of Realtors. So welcome you guys, and thank you for joining us today. Andre, I have your mind. Yeah, I figured you might get a headache staring into that bright light. Okay, let's go ahead and start. So one of the first questions that we had today was, explain what different ways you are using Periscope in your business, or how you can use Periscope in your business. So why don't we start with our new panelists joining us. So why don't we start with Andre, if that's okay.
All right, so I'm not a power user by any means, but any of you that know me, I like to at least see what techie tools are useful. I like to use it, I'm starting to do a few rehab and flip houses, so it's a nice process to show the before, during, and after, as far as, hey, look what I did from this 8-year-old empty, vacant, burned down house to everything is new now except the foundation. Also, the only thing I would disagree with the speaker on is I do use it for open houses. A lot of times, a virtual open house, a late at night open house, people can't be there, but I have about 800 followers on Twitter, so I don't have any tolling on Periscope. But they do engage, and they will give comments and feedback to, don't like this, don't like that, and they're very open and honest.
It's amazing how open and honest people can be on social media, huh? So I don't do a lot of trying to educate the public on real estate, because when they're in social media, they're not wanting to learn about real estate. They're wanting to see my kids. They're wanting to see my office or something silly we're doing in the office or having fun. So I really use it to connect with people. A little bit earlier, I actually kind of put Jennifer on the spot and said, hey, I want to Periscope you. Let's do a little interview. Tell me why you want to run for NAR director. Put her on the spot completely. And started live streaming it. And the YPN chair from San Antonio, Texas, hopped on and said, hello from YPN San Antonio. So if you're using hashtags, people can find you very, very easily. And with Periscope automatically sending to your other social media channels that you're currently live, anybody that's following you there is gonna see that. So that's kind of what I do.
I don't know if anybody saw this. Some of you do follow me on Twitter, and I do appreciate that. And I know some of you might have done so while I'm in the room. I appreciate that as well. Throughout the month of December, we did something called the 31 Days of LinkedIn. It was about as exciting as you could think it would be. But we were doing a lot of content about LinkedIn, but we were also live streaming on Periscope, testing the Periscope app, the Periscope audience, the Periscope everything. Pretty much everything we talked about here today was developed through those 31 days. It was basically a laboratory, all leading up to today. The thing about the Periscope, so we've done 40 or 50 Periscopes by this point now. The audience is online at night, which Andre just mentioned. Your social media audience, if you're in Missouri, we've done hundreds of campaigns on Facebook, social media in Missouri for the last 10 years. 7:30 to 9:30, just are the prime time hours, just like in television. It works that way in social media as well. It's most likely people that are actually going to do business with you, which is who you really need to focus all your efforts on. I know the guy from San Antonio was cool to hang out with, but that's not somebody that can buy a house from you, right?
He's absolutely somebody that will refer business to you.
I am. Because of your example there. So do focus on building audiences that can actually do business with you.
So I'm back. Very good. Great. Thank you for those answers. Let's go into another one that we have here. How is Periscope different from other social media or video marketing tools that you guys may be using?
I'll take that. It's live. So when you make a mistake or you're like, oh, I didn't mean to say that, it's all there. It's all there. But the thing is, that's what makes it fun. Because you can just be you. Whoops, I didn't mean to say that. And move on to something else. So
the live mess ups gets a response every time, and then people go, oh, they're real, this is real. Yeah, that's not fun, but I don't like to be on the camera, so usually I'm either watching someone else teach something or some beautiful place I'm never gonna visit. So for me, it's completely different because I like to talk, but I don't like to physically be on camera. So that's why it's a little hard for me to get used to the concept of sit down at my desk and throw the camera over there and let it go.
Yeah, I'm not big on doing that either.
Because there's no editing. Your editing is after the fact if you're not doing it live.
Well, and if you're periscoping, it is live.
You can do a periscope, so it's not all open as well. So
but that takes the fun out of it. You do the periscope.
Exactly. You don't get the interaction and all the people.
Or you're scoping after midnight.
And there's a lot of creepers that will ask you to take their clothes off. I don't care what you're doing. They will ask.
That's only Andre. They don't ask me that.
I knew I recognized you, Andre.
TMI. One of the other cool things that I do like about Periscope a lot.